The year of 2016 is nearing its end, and with it we saw the rise of two new graphics APIs to hit the market, namely DirectX 12 and Vulkan. There was a lot of hype surrounding these two new technologies in 2015. The question now is, which one is better and which one is likely to reign king in the future? Before we can get into determining the answer to this question right now, let's take a quick look at what DX12 and Vulkan actually are in case you're not too sure yourself. In its basic form, DirectX 12 and Vulkan are the successors to DirectX 11 and OpenGL respectively. What they do is essentially allow your games to speak with your graphics card, which will then send those images from your games directly to your screen. So in essence, these two pieces of technology are simply methods on how to draw graphics to your screen. What makes these two so special though, you might ask? Well, the idea behind Vulkan and DirectX 12 is that game developers like EA, Square Enix, Valve, and others can get closer access to the metal of your graphics card, which in theory should grant you better performance and a few other neat new things. If you didn't already know, this is what is done on consoles. Developers have very close control directly to the metal of the machines. Consoles, in comparison to computers, have very low-end hardware. So if they didn't do this way, they wouldn't be able to make great-looking games for those systems. Previous technologies like DirectX 11 and OpenGL did a lot of the thinking and adjusting for game developers, which meant good stability, but many times meant we may also be losing out on some performance that could otherwise have been squeezed out by the game developer if they had more control. So that basically summarizes what DirectX 12 and Vulkan are. So let's list out the computer games that currently use these two new pieces of technology. Now that's quite a list, considering it's been 7 months since Vulkan's release and a year and a half for DirectX 12's release. You're probably looking at this and thinking to yourself, wow, DirectX 12 is really dominating the market. You would be correct, but it's not for the reasons you likely might be thinking though. Do take note that among that list, 7 out of 16 of them are Microsoft titles. This includes Rise of the Tomb Raider due to the Xbox timed exclusive deal. That's almost 44% of entire games released with DirectX 12 being owned and or developed by Microsoft themselves, the guys who made DirectX 12. You see, DirectX 12 has actually been in the hands of game developers for many years before this year. This is an important point for when we come to our conclusion, so it would do you well to remember it. Back in 2012, Square Enix posted a real-time tech demo for Final Fantasy titled Agni's Philosophy. In early 2015, Square Enix showed this tech demo again, 3 years later, with DirectX 12 implemented at Microsoft's event. To be able to come out with it at this point in time meant that they had early access to it at least since 2014. To be clear, Microsoft announced DirectX 12 at GDC on March 2014, and then they officially released it later in July 2015. That means a working implementation of DirectX 12 with proper drivers already existed in 2014. That's 2 years and several months ago from this video. 2 years, and 44% of the games that have DirectX 12 are only made by Microsoft themselves. This is one of the key factors of how Microsoft keeps its DirectX stranglehold on the market. Now, in contrast to DirectX 12, Vulkan only officially finalized the specification at the end of 2015 and released in February of 2016. Despite Vulkan coming so late to the party, one company did have an earlier tech demo of it up before drivers were available to other developers. This company was Valve, and they showed it off with Dota 2 in March of 2015. They could do this because they were assisting in creating Vulkan itself. So in the timeline of things, DirectX 12 started existing to the general public in visible form earlier than Vulkan did. So why is DirectX 12 talked about so much? Now, one of the critical points of DirectX 12 hype originated from the following Ars Technica article in 2015. This is sort of where it all started. It essentially showed less performance for Nvidia, but a large performance gain for AMD in a game called Ashes of the Singularity. This led to a lot of talk, hype, and interest in asynchronous compute, which is what allowed AMD's hardware to excel here, but leave Nvidia in the dust. I wonder though, is this really the only reason that this is the case? Or is it a fault of the DirectX 12 tech being hardware vendor specific? Or is the technology itself flawed? Let's get to that, shall we? What's more important now though is that with quite a few DirectX 12 titles out now, we're seeing new benchmarks. And so far, these benchmarks have not been very good news for DirectX 12 all around. Let's dig into the reality of the here and now for DirectX 12 and see if that Ars Technica hype still holds any value. Now, in that Ars Technica hype, it was proclaimed that it provided AMD with a 70% boost, which is why it got so much of the wow factor. Taking a look at Gamers Nexus's recent benchmarks of Battlefield 1, we actually see from the graphs that both AMD and Nvidia lose performance when switching to DirectX 12. This happens at both 1080p resolutions and 4K. So there's no room for doubt that it's a resolution-related problem. What's even more important is that GamerNexus states that switching to DirectX 12 introduces higher frame times and perceptible stutters. For those who may not know what this means, it essentially means that using DirectX 12 makes Battlefield 1 feel less smooth and have moments where the screen may look like it's stopped or hanged. At this point, I'd imagine you'd likely type something like the following: DirectX 12 is still new. It's not fair to compare it right now. As I've gone over the previous point, it's not brand new. It's essentially been available to these developers for at least 2 years now. They may have even had access to it earlier. You may go on to voice out then, well, it could just be that Battlefield 1 sucks because EA sucks. On this point, I'll take you up and say, okay, maybe it's just Battlefield 1 that's the problem, and not DirectX 12. So let's see what other titles have been benchmarked and their results. Jumping to Deus Ex Mankind Divided, benchmarked by Guru3D here, when we switch to DirectX 12, we lose performance on Nvidia by a performance delta of around 3% upwards to 14%. We do gain a small delta of performance anywhere from 5% to 15% on AMD here, but nothing near what Ars Technica was hyping about. That 70%, we're not seeing it here. So we're trying to see if that hype was deserved, but so far still, it doesn't look like it was. In this benchmark, the R9 Fury X with DirectX 12 was still unable to beat the GTX 1080 with DX11. Despite the asynchronous compute, the disparity between the vendors was still unfair and favored Nvidia. So at this point, your comment is probably along the lines of, ha, I told you so, DirectX 12 is good, just that it's only good for AMD. Even if it's not letting AMD beat Nvidia yet, I'd still call that a win in my books. To which I'd say, but what if we had a graphics API that let all three hardware vendors, Intel, AMD, Nvidia, gain performance over past gen technologies without any vendor being sacrificed? Now I've probably got you thinking at this point, and that's good. We want to question whether DirectX 12 is really the answer and if it's good for us at all. Time to press on. Looking at Total War Warhammer benchmarked by PC Gamer, jumping to DirectX 12, once again, Nvidia loses performance with a delta of around 5 to 10%, which is what we've been seeing so far. AMD gains 20 to 25% this time around. You might be thinking, whoa, 20 to 25%, that sounds amazing. It's not actually. These percentages are a statistical lie. The AMD performance here is less than what we just saw in Deus Ex Mankind Divided. In DXMD, the R9 Fury X was only behind the 1080. But here though, in TWW, the R9 Fury X on DirectX 12 drops even further behind and is behind the GTX 980 Ti at DX11 levels. What's still frustrating to see here is that DirectX 12 makes Nvidia lose performance, and whilst it gives AMD a slight bit of performance, it still keeps AMD in the losing bracket as well. So DirectX 12 so far doesn't seem to be shaping up as the next gen API it's supposed to be. So let's look at some of Candyland's YouTube side-by-side comparisons of DirectX 12 versus DirectX 11. We start off with Rise of the Tomb Raider. On the 980 Ti, it's between indifference and loss of performance when switching to DirectX 12, which is bad. This is from a title that Microsoft had its firm grip on during development. You'd expect better things than this. From the same guys over at Candyland, jumping into the AMD side of things with the R9390X, one of AMD's cards that are supposed to gain the highest performance with DirectX 12, actually loses frames per second. It's so significant, it's sickening to see. This is back into the Battlefield 1 results we saw earlier. Now it seems like DirectX 12 has it out for both AMD and Nvidia by killing performance for both of them. Remember, Microsoft had their hands on this title exclusively, and Microsoft are the makers of DirectX 12. This was their baby. They didn't let this happen. What it really is that they couldn't stop it from happening. We're starting to see the ugliness of DirectX 12 even clearer now. Still not convinced? Doesn't feel good enough? Alright, let's jump to Hitman now. With the GTX 980, DirectX 12 is borderline once again insignificant or either a loss of performance for Nvidia. Moving to AMD's R9390X again, this time things are a little saner, but still nowhere they should be. We see at best 10 frames per second improvement, or otherwise it's literally indifference. What's happening here? Worse yet, in the same game Hitman, when we jump to an AMD 280X, AMD is suddenly once again losing performance under DirectX 12. What the hell? Why is DirectX 12 so inconsistent as an API? I'm not the only one to think something's seriously wrong with DirectX 12. Look at all these commentators and their feelings on the matter. We're not alone in thinking that the DirectX 12 hype is really not what it's claimed to be. One more game to drive the point through with how bad DirectX 12 is. Quantum Break, Microsoft's own game. We're looking at some footage from Digital Foundry here. In this instance, not only does DirectX 12 lose out to DirectX 11 for Nvidia cards like we've consistently seen so far, it brings nothing to the table for AMD. AMD's performance in DirectX 12 is identical to DirectX 11. What's the point? And because it's shoehorning AMD's performance, it keeps the RX 480 losing to the GTX 680, when in fact the RX 480 has greater potential. If this was Vulkan, the RX 480 would be on top. But at the same time, the GTX 1060 would also get a nice boost. In this case, DX12 is doing no one any favors. It's completely useless in this title. At this point, I'm assuming that both Nvidia and AMD users who are watching are disappointed with DirectX 12 in some way. How can a next-gen API be causing so much loss of performance for both card vendors over a slew of different games? It's clearly not a single instance problem. It's not a case of a single news provider skewing things. It's not a single publisher problem. It's not a hardware vendor problem. Both AMD and Nvidia are not getting the performance improvements they should be able to get with a close-to-the-metal API like they're supposed to. DirectX 12 is the issue here. We're supposed to be seeing all-around improvements. So this is where we're going to take a look at the alternative, Vulkan. Vulkan titles are limited right now. That much is true. Microsoft's money really penetrates the market. So we only have three to look at right now. Hopefully 2017 turns that around, as we need this tech in more games. We start off looking at Doom. As Eurogamer points out, Doom gained performance across the board for both Nvidia and AMD when using Vulkan. This is what a next-gen graphics API should be doing, ensuring that all vendors benefit from it. AMD gets the large performance boost thanks to its Async compute, and Nvidia gets a solid performance boost for being close to the metal as well. Now you might point out that this is a Vulkan versus OpenGL comparison though, and not Vulkan versus DirectX 11. You would be correct. So why is it still relevant then, you might ask? Nvidia's OpenGL driver is as good as their DirectX 11 driver. So where DirectX 12 causes Nvidia to lose performance, we can expect Vulkan to help it gain performance. That is to say, where Vulkan provides a boost over OpenGL, we can expect it to do the same thing over DirectX 11. In AMD, their OpenGL driver is not that great, which is the same scenario for their DirectX 11 driver. So if Vulkan can give AMD that boost over OpenGL, naturally we can expect to see the same thing when Vulkan is used over DirectX 11 for AMD cards. Essentially, Vulkan has the benefits of DirectX 12, but without the performance loss and inconsistencies that seem to plague DirectX 12. Let's look at some DirectX 12 versus Vulkan benchmarks though. Telos Principle is up next, and we take a look at how Vulkan support for it has changed since it first released. If we were to take a look at GamerNexus's first video, Vulkan doesn't do well against DirectX 11. Don't panic though, the Talos Principle developers themselves said this was expected because their implementation of Vulkan was still in its infancy at the time. So let me show you where Talos Principle is at now with Vulkan against DirectX 11, at least on my GTX 1070. To make a short story of it, the 1070 now operates better with Vulkan than DirectX 11 by at least 9 frames per second on average. By right, if this was DirectX 12, it would be performing worse than DirectX 11. Better yet though, this is whilst the developer is still saying that they haven't fully completed Vulkan support, which means that there's a potential future improvement. Unfortunately, I don't have an RX 480 to test, otherwise I'm sure we would see even better results on Vulkan compared to DirectX 11. So let's take a look at one more DirectX 11 versus Vulkan benchmark. Before going into my own Dota 2 benchmark test, we're gonna have a quick look at YouTube channel Dr. Sneak's comparison of DirectX 11 against Vulkan on his GTX 970. He has a consistently better performance on Vulkan compared to DirectX 11. Now onto my own Dota 2 quick bench. I'm running through a very heavy scene in Dota 2 Update 7 here, and the results are in favor of Vulkan over DirectX 11. Here Vulkan fights directly with DirectX 11 on this GTX 1070, but ultimately Vulkan takes the lead by having more FPS on average than DirectX 11 overall. I'd say we've reached a point where we can now make a conclusion. You might be wondering why there was no direct comparison between DirectX 12 and Vulkan. This is because no game has dared yet to include both technologies into itself. Any game that has DirectX 12 has a contract with Microsoft and will unlikely ever see a Vulkan addition. At least for now, it's pretty clear that DirectX 12 is an unstable piece of technology that seems to be doing more harm than good. Whereas on the other hand, Vulkan is offering across the board improvements for all hardware vendors. At this point, I sincerely believe, as a gamer, a consumer, and a customer, that we should be demanding for Vulkan in games for the computer platform, not DirectX 12. I don't wish for DirectX 12 to die, but I instead hope that it will take a backseat this generation. It's clearly just a tool Microsoft is using to try and tie us into the Windows Store, but even that's not working in their favor. It's a tool that is seemingly losing its purpose more and more as time goes by. So simply put, right now at the time of this video, I genuinely believe Vulkan is the better option than DirectX 12. I really do believe it has the potential to reign king in the future. So I've done the best I can to present this point with data to back it up in this video, and I've attempted to source data from as many different sources as possible to paint a realistic picture. But you may still feel differently on the matter. Do you despise Vulkan? Is DirectX 12 possibly gaming's best future in your opinion? Or do you feel the same positive greatness about Vulkan as I do? What are your thoughts and arguments on the topic? Share it with us in the comments down below. And if you feel this was a well done video, well, please go ahead and leave me a like. If you hated it, go ahead and press that dislike then. It's your life, do with it as you will. With all that said and done, a year from now, the landscape of computer gaming could be so different that nothing we can attempt to predict right now may happen. Nonetheless, I thank you for watching.